Yeah. It's just my life. Front to back, top to bottom.
Everything's changing around me. These days don't feel the same. We all lost faith and lost family. Why must we play this game? Lord, have mercy on me. I've been a sinning man.
Pull out my wings, jump off the bridge, I'm crashing a plane. If I never land, no, I never die. We live forever in my mind. And I sanctify. We live forever, still alive.
There's a lot going on, but I stick to the ones I love. I never claimed to be a perfect man, but name a great man who was. Consequences of my actions in the past years had me stressing out. It was like May, I just moved to LA, I was trying to figure it out. Medication for depression that I cut cold turkey, had the kid manic. In an episode out in Hollywood, wildin' out like Nick Cannon. Railing at a raw pills, out a dollar bill on the bathroom floor. Clean the whole mess up with my nose, what the fuck I need a vacuum for? New York City on my birthday, June 6, 2014. I had that first meeting with Hov, plus I brought out the whole team. I drank that whole bottle of Douce, Ty gave me that night. When we left the club at the Rap Genius house, me and Shorty got into a fight. She came out the room swinging, hit me in the jaw. I was really trying to fend her off, but I ended up in the closet with my hands around her neck. I was tripping, dog. Too proud to apologize or empathize, I blamed it all on her, saying that she hit me first, even though she was the one hurt. I was really just reflecting all the hurt that I was feeling from the band's rejection. When kids these days split, that shit felt like a C-section. And my infidelity and jealousy with Natalie on top of the amphetamines and the ecstasy had me trying to drown face down in the Chesapeake. The next month I dropped down on my luck and had Europe going nuts, but I couldn't even appreciate it at the time. I was going through too much. Now I had the leverage, $1 million label deals on the table for my records. In the Ibiza eating pie yellow on the roof, trying to choose over breakfast. Hov wasn't with the bidding war, but I knew the rock just felt right. When I saw Kanye Wireless without T-Pain, still a good life, felt so close. When Mr. Hudson introduced me to him backstage, he probably don't even remember that shit, like a bitch off Backpage. But at that stage, I was ready to swing for the fence like a batting cage. At the same time, I was winding down a low point in my addict phase. The Adderall started wearing off and I went into a deep writer's block. All over a song I couldn't finish that I wrote about shining to the rock. Isn't that ironic? I was feeling so psychotic, with the whole world excited for me and my idol saying I got it. Shit got bad out in LA, so I moved back home to my mom's basement. Linked up with Smoke on Poppy Beats and took it back to basics. Then I wrote Rage, that was me screaming out through the pain. And you mad, addressing my relationship with Natalie, you was too bad. The violence and the lies slipped suicide into my mental health. I did acid in the studio one day and almost killed myself. As I started to fall apart, certain stars started to align. Omaz came to Chicago in January at the perfect time. He said Kanye was working on an album and Uzi played him one of our songs. He was trying to fly me out, nigga, it was going down like the Dow Jones. Pulled up to Westlake, first day I was there, I recorded Wolves. I knew I was the one, like Neo meeting with the Oracle. But I had to get a handle before the door was pulled. Crawled out on SNL, all the niggas hating on me back home, looking at me like FML. A lot of people coming out the wood like Let's Work, trying to network. All the pressure making my head hurt, the Molly wouldn't let the meds work. At this time it's like Feb 1st or the 15th and I'm still addicted. Frustrated, writing shit for Ye, trying to visualize someone else's vision. Then he laid that verse on You Mad and we made this shit a single. Ye and Hov getting into it over me, trying to do a joint venture. And good music still fam, but it's that rock boy save money life. Took the bus out on the road for the traffic tour, did 100 nights. Cleaned out my closet, I got rid of all of my demons. If you learn one thing from my journey, niggas don't stop believing. When this shit got so suffocating, I could barely even keep breathing. Wrote my wrongs all in this song, now I'd like to welcome y'all to my season. Nigga, I'm gone.